a little over 20 years ago, I donated my blood plasma to help burn victims. And 2 weeks after I donated it, I woke up with night sweats. It's weird. It was like my head was drenched, my chest was drenched. It was like someone poured water on me. Strange. It was very strange. And I discovered that I was exposed to hepatitis B. Possibly due to someone not cleaning the machine that I literally shared bodily fluids with. Because what it did, it took my blood out, separated the plasma, and then put my blood cells back into my body using a saline solution. I remember feeling kind of cold because it wasn't exactly 98.7. It was more like 95 or something like that, you know. So I just felt like it was bizarre. I felt chilly, even though it was warm and hot. And anyway, when I got the news back that my blood plasma had been rejected and that there's a warning sign on me, and I was being asked questions like, do you engage in gay sex? Do you share needles? When was your last sexual encounter, et cetera, et cetera. It was like, what? I don't do any of that, you know? I mean, really, it was like, here I'm trying to help people, burn victims, and then I get a sleazy disease that, you know, drug addicts and gay guys get, you know? It just, you know... I felt like, you know, why God? You know, I just, it just seemed like a joke, you know, because I was trying to do the right thing, you know, by not having premarital sex, you know, didn't want to break the law by taking legal drugs and things like that. But let's put it this way. I was living a very, what you would call an uneventful life. And, I thought, wow, this is really strange. And then it was kind of funny because I thought maybe they're lying to me. Maybe I don't have hepatitis B. Maybe they had a machine. They found out that the machine might have had HIV in it, and they were just covering their bases. You know, that they actually contaminated with HIV, and that I had AIDS. That was going through my mind. And they were just saying it was hepatitis B. So it was really funny, in a way. But anyway, the thing that got me through that and kept me from being an atheist is that the Bible says that God is no respecter of persons, that the rain falls on the just and the unjust, that God is a hidden God. And of course, you know, there's a story about the prodigal son where the elder brother stays home and doesn't go off... you know, having fun, and while the other brother, well, that the younger brother came back and he did all that stuff, you know, and is still, you know, loved by the dad. I began to realize that God loves me just as much as that starving little kid in Africa with his eyes caked with flies, loves me just as much as the Hell's Angel who's creating mayhem and stuff like that. In other words, it seems like I'm worshiping an impersonal God, you know? Even though the Bible says God's not impersonal. And I know it sounds kind of, you know, makes you feel like you really don't matter, you know, that you really don't... that it's kind of like an atheistic view of God, like almost like as if I'm denying the power thereof. See how, you know,